Welcome to your dream and his interpretation today. I am Paul S. Joshua. I'm glad to be back again to handle the dreams you have sent. Don't forget to always try to let me know where you are sending your dream from, and your name is part of the rule, and it's very important, okay? When you are sending your dream, let me know your name, let me know who I'm interpreting dream for, and then as well, let me know where you are sending your dream from. I got so many dreams. I'm really sorry I can't take all the dream at the times. I got so many text messages. I got so many mails. I also got many on YouTube. And there are some on Facebook. All right, but I'll try. Like I said, it's continuous exercise. So I will do the little I can within the time of my coverage today. And then tomorrow we'll continue. So in case I didn't interpret yours, or those of you have sent yours for quite some time, please, you have to bear with me. Okay, I'll try one by one to address them, okay, in subsequent episodes. It's important. Like this video as you watch them and let me know how everything here is blessing you that I'm doing here. I start today with a dream that came from Violet. On my mail, I got your dream, Violet, all the way from UK. All right, you said your husband had a dream that we both moved to a new house. The windows were all glazes. Our neighbors, mini mobile caravan detached from the attachment at the back of their car, and this mini caravan rolled into our front glass and window, and it just punctured and cracked it. My husband came out of the house to confront the neighbor, and I followed him as well. All the neighbor had to say was that we should get our insurance to repair it for us. I shouted at him, saying the damage, he damaged it, if you like, and he should fix it. Just as I was saying this, the cracked glazed window shattered to pieces and fell off. This made me upset, and my husband was calming me down. Then he woke up. Okay, Pastor, what does this mean? Violet from UK. All right, Violet from UK, your dream is actually a sensitive dream. Okay, in this context, that's to say you and your husband had a new decision you have taken, and this new decision, you must be very careful, because the enemy is not happy with the new decision that your family have taken. I'm sure there's something new you are up to, you and your husband, and the devil want to make sure he spoil your new decision, your new plan. So I will recommend you pray seriously that the plans that you have just taken as a family, the devil will not frustrate your plan. That's what I'm seeing here. The enemy is not happy with something you're about to do. There is a decision that you and your husband have taken that actually will move your family to the next level, and the enemy wants to make sure that he spoils that plan and frustrate that decision, okay? So you pray against any enemy plan against your family, that plan be frustrated and the enemy will not succeed. The Lord will keep your family strong in Jesus' name. That's your dream, please. Violet, all the way from UK, protect your family. Okay, God bless you. And I got this next dream. The next dream comes from Small World or so. Small World, you said, what does it mean to shave off your hair in the dream? Okay, that is somebody shave off your hair. Small World, if you are a lady, I will suggest you pray that you don't lose your dignity, all right? You don't lose your dignity, your pride. Any attempt to steal something that makes your life colorful, the devil should not succeed on you. That's your dream. Okay, Small World, that's from Louisiana in USA. So you pray against every plan of the devil to steal your dignity, all right? That should be frustrated. That's your dream, okay? Good. And the next dream came from Ifwa, all the way from Philadelphia in USA. And then you said that you had a dream you fell into a big river and couldn't swim, so was drowning, and then came up for air. Then I woke up. All right. And the second dream, you said someone was giving out luggages. I yelled I wanted one, and when I want to get it, I wanted to give them money, but I didn't have any money. I told them I will be right back, and went to borrow $20 from a lady, and she gave me $10 instead. And I was on my way back to get the luggage. A lady appeared and told me I was owing $5, and she taking me to court June 1st. I refused to pay her, and told her I see her in court. And the third dream, you said you are donating blood, but as they tried to get it, nothing came out. All right, if you are from Philadelphia, USA, your dream, all the three dreams actually point to one message. And what is your dream? Yeah, you have to be very prayerful. You don't get into a very big mess, a big problem that you won't be able to handle, okay? and this is what your dream is all about. So I do suggest, if while you pray and be very careful, this is a big trial coming your way, a trial that you might not be able to handle, something very big that is going to look like a challenge, okay, that want to take your peace, take your joy, and cost you everything that you've got. So you must be prayerful. If you be very prayerful, honestly, it's a big problem coming, a big challenge, big trial. But all I know is that if you have God on your side, you're going to overcome the trial, you overcome the challenge. All right, that's my prayer for you, that every trial coming your way, you will overcome that trial. No tragedy will knock you down in the name of Jesus. God will give you victory, and you will triumph over it. So that's your dream. All right, please pray and be careful. That's your dream, please. Okay, I got another one from Farren. Farren Banwell? I don't know if I pronounce your name well. Farren Banwell, you have also sent your dream for some time now. I'm sorry I'll not be able to attend to you. You said you have a recurrent dream of my old high school, and every time I reach the season to graduate, I start the year, you restart the year, then time for exams, I'm frustrated and can't understand and can't even focus. All right, Farren Banwell, okay, a dream from US too. I want you to pray and ask God for grace to overcome the spirit of confusion. All right, you're full of confusion, your anxiety, you are worried about so many things. All right, that's what your dream is, and you have to be very prayerful. All right, and God will help you. You need to be very organized. You have spirit of confusion all around you, and then you're also, as a result of anxiety, you're always having anxiety, you're worried, you're depressed about so many things at a time. So pray against that. That is Farren Banwell, spirit of confusion, spirit of anxiety, you are depressed. So you pray against spiritual depression, and you need to work out and have some things to exalt you so you can overcome that. I frustrate that spirit of stagnation in your life and set back in Jesus' name, victory for you. That's your dream, from Farren Banwell, all the way from US. Okay, I got a dream from Adesoka Ulua Bukola Caleb from Kebbi State, Nigeria. From Kebbi State, Nigeria, you said, I saw myself combating with a known man inside a river and was able to conquer him. But on my way out of the river, some set of men grabbed and tied me and was calling on a man to shoot me with a gun. But before his arrival, a delegate from my church came with two wrapped gifts and were presented to the men. Then I was freed. That is from Ade Sokan Olua Bukola Caleb, Kebbi State, Nigeria. You want to know what this dream means? All right, you were combating with a man you know and inside the river, and then you were able to conquer him, and they were trying to come out. Some people pick you up, grab you, until a delegate came from a church and rescue you because they wanted to shoot you a gun. Well, this is actually a very serious battle here. You're going to face a battle, of course, and this battle has to do with your career. You're running into a big problem in your career, but God is going to arrange a way out for you. And don't forget, as you conquer that battle in your career, also some enemy going to rise up. You know, every victory also attracts another victory. I mean, attract another challenge or envy. So what I see here is you having a victory, and a victory in your career also provoking another level of envy. And this envy will require God's intervention. The people from your church has to do with God's intervention. People of God praying for you to get over it. And that is what God is showing you. So be very sensitive, because the enemy is not happy with you. You overcome, having triumph in your career, and then the devil wants to attack you again, even with sickness and infirmity. But with the help of prayers from your church people, that is godly people praying for you, you are going to overcome the problem. That is what God is showing you here. So be very careful, be prayerful, and then have some prayer point in form of, Lord, every challenge against my career, every challenge against my health, every bunch of enemy coming against me, Lord, frustrate their life over me, frustrate their counsel over me, and God will give you victory. So the church member there stands for the people of God praying for you. God will raise people to pray for you, and you will overcome all the challenge that might come from everywhere. That is from Adesoka Olua Bukola Caleb, all the way from Kebbi State, Nigeria. God bless you, and I pray it is well with you. The enemy will not overcome you now, because I'm going to stop here because of my time on this video. But all other ones that I'm here to take your own, especially those of you who have sent a lot of text messages, I'll continue in the subsequent episode. And also from Facebook, I have some people that I'm trusting God for grace to be able to take yours. Also, I don't want long video, all right? And I'm going to make sure tomorrow I continue from where I stop, okay? And don't forget to like my video as well, to share this video with your colleagues, and also to always drop your comments. Let me know how this video have really blessed you, if at all it did, and then confirm if I interpret your dream and then what I said is exactly what is happening in your life. Let me know. All right, it's very important to appreciate what I'm doing here. And I must also thank all of you who have been encouraging us on this program. I appreciate you. I celebrate you, as well those of you who are doing everything possible to make sure that this ministry is progressing. I appreciate you. I love you so much. You can get my book on Amazon, Your Dream and Interpretation, on Amazon, okay? The click will always be below. That book will be of great help to you, all right? I love all of you, my friends, my fans. Tell me how much you love this program, okay? I celebrate you. Keep dreaming great. Have good dreams, all right? And knowing what your dream is, like I always say, is vital to your safety. I see you again in the next episode tomorrow, okay? God bless you. I am Paul S. Joshua. Tell me how much you love me. I love you too. God bless you. Bye.